Welcome to a new planetary and seismic update. You see the SSGI graph here from the previous time frame with earthquakes magnitude 5.5 and larger. And as you can see, later on the first, we did have a stronger earthquake. It didn't reach magnitude 7. It stayed actually at 6.4, 6.5 magnitude at the Bougainville region in Papua New Guinea. Then with the red peaks, in the second half of this time frame, we see these obvious clustering of stronger earthquakes, including 2 6-pointers, especially on the 5th. Remember, I said 5-6 initially. There could be a seismic response to the planetary geometry that we had on the 4th in particular. And indeed, we see this clustering 6.2 near the north coast of New Guinea, and also 5.7 Bolivia, and 5.5 at the Arrecifes Ridge near Iceland. And also San Juan, Argentina on the 6th, and strong earthquakes also on the 7th, 8th. That is a 6-pointer at Tonga. I will come to that again in a minute. And 5.5 at the Solomon Islands. So we see these high red-purple peaks on the 5th, as I mentioned in the previous update. That was a clustering or convergence of planetary conjunction, and also later on the 7th, 8th, which is a tight convergence. And basically, we had 6 planetary conjunctions in 2-3 days, which is a lot. And as I also said, on the 9th, 10th, that's today, tomorrow, there can be an obvious seismic response to those 6 planetary conjunctions that could reach magnitude 7. Could be a pretty strong shake around the 10th, could be later today, tomorrow, not sure. It very much depends on the stress levels in Earth's crust. But this is very significant. Also on the 7th, 8th, we have 2 lunar peaks that I also mentioned in the previous update. So let's have a look at the SGI graph for the next time frame. That is from the 9th until the 17th of September. And like I said, the first 2 weeks of September, there may be stronger earthquakes above average. And we also saw that in the second half of the previous time frame. And this may actually continue in the coming week. As you can see, we have quite some planetary conjunctions, primarily involving Venus. Mercury is not so much in there, and that makes things a little bit uncertain. Whenever Venus aligns with an outer planet, as we will have on the 9th, 10th, early on the 10th actually, and also on the 11th and on the 12th, in all cases, we have Venus in a planetary conjunction, 4 in total. And again, when that happens with an outer planet, there can be a major earthquake. There is actually about 80-85% probability of a major earthquake when Venus reaches this geometry of outer planets. In the solar system, we see this planetary geometry. Purple marks the conjunctions with Venus. And we see Venus, Mercury, and Jupiter, and that will be on the 12th. On the 12th, there will be a convergence of planetary and lunar conjunctions. We have also have Venus with Sun, Mars, and Uranus. That's not a tight quadruple conjunction, but it is a near quadruple conjunction. That means we have 4 planetary conjunctions as a result. That's Venus, Sun, Mars, Venus, Sun, Uranus, and also Sun, Mars, and Uranus. And that will be happening primarily on the from the 10th to the 12th. And there can be an obvious seismic response as a result, also because the lunar geometry converges pretty much with that planetary geometry. Back on the SGI graph, we see that Moon, Earth, Uranus, Moon, Earth, Jupiter, and Moon, Earth, Mars. That happens from the 9th to the 12th, basically at the same time as we have this planetary geometry. So we see in the first half of this time frame, this critical planetary geometry and lunar geometry converging. And again, because Venus is primarily involved here, things are a little bit uncertain. But be on watch, there can be a major response, a major seismic response to this planetary geometry. I mentioned the Tonga earthquake, magnitude 6, and if we look at the atmospheric fluctuations, on the 6th we had fluctuations marking the region of Tonga, and within a day or 1-2 days, we had this strong earthquake magnitude 6 right there at Tonga. And if you look at the antipode symmetry, that is in the South Atlantic, that could mark the South Sandwich Islands, but also to the north, southern Italy and Greece. Greece is a question mark right now because Greece can have strong earthquakes magnitude 6, and it's been a while, and so I inclined to say that Greece is due for a stronger earthquake. To the north, we have Romania, the Carpathian Mountains. It can also be a candidate for a strong seismic event. The severity is strong, it's not major, going by the atmospheric fluctuations. And this happened on the 6th, but also on the 8th, we had several atmospheric fluctuations. Check out the website and also our social media channels for the latest updates. Remember, atmospheric fluctuations, this method is very much in its infancy. It's prone to error. We're still in a development state here. And it can be significant, but it's no guarantee. And this is primarily because we do not know the stress levels in Earth's crust. I cannot say this enough. We don't know the stress levels in Earth's crust. So it's not like we look at the planets and say, okay, there's going to be an earthquake in this location or that location. It doesn't work like that. It is a global seismic weather related to planetary and lunar geometry. This is the update for now. Again, check out the website and the latest updates in our social media channels. Stay safe. Until next time.